Yes, madam.
Yeah. Am I audible, sir?
Yes,
good afternoon, sir. Yeah.
Principal father, no,
principal.
Sir.
Yeah. Ah, sir. Father.
Yes, sir. I'm ready. You can begin.
Yeah. Shall we start, father? Are we late?
Yes, five minutes. No, it's time, no? You said 3 o'clock, half an hour you're waiting.
Yes, father. Yes. 3:30, father. Exact time is 3:30.
There are some who are unmuted. Awesome, everybody to mute.
Father?
There are some who are ask them to mute. Nagaraju, something, Samadhi.
Please, all the participants, please mute your audio and video, please. It's my humble It's my humble request. Please mute your audio and video. We'll wait five minutes, Father. I request all the participants to please mute your audio and video and don't share your screen. And please pin the speaker to view his presentation and post your questions in the chat box. Father, shall we start, Father?
Yes.
Madam, Professor Garu?
Sir is there.
Shamjagrath is there.
Sir is there.
Okay.
Reverend Father Victor Emmanuel, our beloved principal, Professor K. Somshekhar Rao, today's webinar speaker, Dr. G. A. Prasad Rao, Head Department of Library and Information Science, Father Gordon Library, and all the participants, a very good afternoon. I'm Roja Mani, convener for this webinar. On the behalf of Andhra Loyola College, welcome all the participants to the national webinar on information and learning resources in COVID-19 era. Google can bring you 1 lakh answers. A librarian can bring you the right one. Quoted by Neil Gaiman. Library is the heart and soul of an institution where new ideas are germinated and fertilized. It is a temple of knowledge and a boon to the people. It is the place where knowledge is preserved. Yes, we should be very proud to be a librarian. Our library is established in the year 1954 and named after Reverend Father Douglas Gordon, who was second principal of our college and academic senate member of Andhra University for many years. Our library is enriched with good collection of 130,000 selected books and 120,782 digital collection, including e-books and e-journals, and special collection of palm leaves of Saraswati Sahasranamam and 110 years of National Geography series. Our library is fully automated with NewGen Lib software, with barcoding, and also providing free internet facility with 50 capacity. Dear professionals, as you know, the pandemic has significantly disrupted our lives. It has changed everything in our life, the way we live, work, and even interact with each other. But there is one positive fallout of this lockdown. The curbs have provided an opportunity for self-enrichment and interest in online learning platforms such as UGC Swayam, Udemy, Coursera, so on. Really, this is the need of the hour. Our resource person is an apt person to deliver and discuss on the theme. Now, the schedule of the webinar is as follows. Blessings by Reverend Father G.M. Victor Emmanuel, our beloved principal, then theme talk, followed by question and answer session. Finally, vote of thanks by Dr. G.A. Prasadra. Now, I invite our respected principal, Reverend Father G.M. Victor Emmanuel S.J., to share his blessings.
So, welcome everyone to this particular webinar. On behalf of Garden Library of Andhra Loyola College, headed by Prasad Rao and Roja Mani PG Block, and other dignitaries, and a special welcome to Swami Shekhar Rao from Andhra University, who got retired, and who, all the other persons from other colleges and professors, students, and guests for Loyola webinar. COVID-19 has brought to focus in line the many of the things that are available, e-resources and online resources, online care. Even webinar, you see, this itself is a result of COVID-19. We are not accustomed to have We are not accustomed to have webinar like this. We at least once in a way we used to have now. Now, this COVID has brought in many techniques, many things very near to us and very far away also. They are very, very close and very far. And our librarians are here to make the things nearer, easy, and accessible. During this time, our librarians, especially Prasad Garu and Rojamani Garu, they have, not on this occasion, we want to recognize their contribution to the colleges. They have made several collections of books, PDF format books, and you just need to have a letter written to them, and they will deliver the PDF format to the person within that day itself. So that contribution they made, and it was recognized by CCU, and even Naik Garu recognized their services. I congratulate them, and they also collected many MCQ books. And they are in the circulation. Slowly, we are going to publish them. And they are doing very nice. Even our students need not go to the library. From their home, they just apply and they find out if it is available or not. And if it is available, they apply and the book will be ready. If it is applied, if it is available, the reply will come back within 2 days, 3 days, it will be available, and you come back and then collect. So these are the things they have done. Digitalized and very nice work they have done, and librarians both are taking enormous steps to improve and make the students study. And they also know, like sports persons, these people are popular among the students because they encourage the students to study and they can catch hold of the intelligent ones and help them to achieve their goals. Library is the one which is least visited by people, because they all the nowadays people give notes and they are interested in collecting notes and memorizing them, and they don't go deep down into the subjects, where very few people go there. Now this COVID-19 make the people to go to the libraries. Now they are searching for knowledge, they're searching for the books, they're searching for. Now online classes have started today. We are Andhra Loyola College began the academic year in the morning. So now they are made to work, they're made to search, they are made to not only just whatever material trash that is available, but particularly our librarian, they are helping them to search what way and what they have collected subject wise and provided them and helped them, and they have enormous amount of material dumped in our this one, and it is their job to go and search, and so online connections are there and so many offline connections are given. So I thank them for that. And I also a few words about Gordon. I happen to be a student. 1979-82 I was a student. He was the rector at that time, and I was given chemistry main. I didn't want main. At the time main was the maths main. Statistics, physics were ancillaries. So I didn't want to have a chemistry. I went to rector. At the time very difficult to meet rector, though I was just a student. I straight away went, I didn't want chemistry. I said, I want only maths. Why? He said, I am interested in maths. I got 100 out of 100. I want that only. But we need people on chemistry, he said. But I'm not interested in chemistry because it is smelling, he said. So what smelling? When you go for practicals, not a smell first. Father, immediately, the father who was in charge of me was to meet him. But whereas I straight away went to him and I explained my problem. He was such a gentleman. He did not get angry at all. Simply said, whatever you want, you do it. That's how I landed in taking mathematics as my main. And afterwards, I did my Regents year, and afterwards 26 years I'm working here. I have been with him for a long time. Gordon is a gentleman. Earlier, as you know, the selection was strict place just by, there is no issue to panel earlier. On the corridor, he used to have interviews with the professors, and he used to pick them up. Okay, come and join tomorrow. That's how the interviews take place those days. There were no advertisements. All the rules are changed now. When he was, he and the Thiamathias, when they were principals, they simply appointed by looking at the face, by having a conversation. And their knowledge was so deep. I have not seen fathers of that type later on, such with the depth of their knowledge. It's apt that we have gotten as a name for our library. Library is full of knowledge. It's full of books, but we have only opened them. And I used to ask my students, you don't read, just go to the library and touch them, I said. Because they don't know really the depth of knowledge that is available. If you have a companion, like a book, there's nothing like that. You can enjoy throughout your life. You can enjoy and you can spend hours together. When you retire, you'll have always a companion. Whatever may be, when you have a good book which enriches your mind and soul, that is the best companion you can have. It can enrich whatever way possible. It will trigger. Some of the books speak as if your thoughts. Yeah, that's what I actually wanted to express. Some of them so nice, very simple words, some small poems, small essays, small stories. See, each one has got their own liking. And library caters to everybody. That is, our library has got enough memories. Only we have to instill this knowledge in our students. They want shortcuts. They are not interested in them going to the depth of any of the subjects. We librarians who are in charge, we who are actually taking a lot of interest in this, how much time it takes to write an essay, a beautiful essay, beautiful writing, how much time, unless they understand, they won't go to the library. It's not trash, it's there. Select books, and it's so nice, the books are there, and it is our teacher's job and our job to make them interested, not them interested. And these kind of seminars and webinars help them to understand the importance of library and the importance of information that is available. COVID-19 has given us a lot of free time for us, for the students to browse through, to go through, and the paper is full of so many things, political things, other things, and so many things are there, but the papers have become thin. Papers have become thin because they have nothing else to report except COVID. And there is to be 8 to 9 pages, 10 pages. Now there are not even 4 or 5 pages because they are nothing is happening around the world. Whereas literary circle, there is no stop. Webinars have increased, seminars have increased, writings have increased, people are increased in many things. So I welcome you again, once again. Writers must increase. Writers must go on, and intellectual must put forward, put their writings in. You may die, your book will never die. You may die, but your idea that you have sown will never die. The inspiration will never, never die. So the inspiration that given through the book will be with the student forever and ever. He quote few things here and there. Why? Because he has touched you. You might have written a big book, but one or two will have an impact on us. That is the way to write a book. That is the way to make the students understand. So let me end my opening remarks by saying, so there is a small poem. There is a small poem. Who is a poem like this? I am desolate. I am thrown out. I am depressed. I am not able to bear the pain of all the things that is life. I am segregated. I am oppressed. I am waiting for you to come and sit next to me. He says, out of desperation, these words. I wait for you to come and sit next to me. Who is that? You? Then he says, then the song you might have heard. When you are near, when you are nearby, when you are with me, I can stand on the toppest of mountains. When you are with me, I can walk on the toppest seas, on the stormy seas. And when you are on your shoulders, I can be more than I can be. Only simple words, but they can inspire so many things. That is, when God is with us, we can do so many things. When we have our inspiration with us, we can produce books after books. But we need inspiration. Inspiration is born out of pain. This COVID-19 is a painful experience and era for humanity, which makes the human beings come together, find a solution for one another, find a solution for the epidemic, and let us unite together and try to help one another. The boundaries are created by us. But we let us come together as human beings and help one another. So thanks once again for coming to Loyola College webinar and Prasad and Rojamani for arranging, and especially Swami Shekharrao for accepting our humble invitation and coming to Loyola College to render his lecture. All the best. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you very much for your encouraging words and your blessings, Father. Thank you so much. Now this is the time to introduce our today's speaker, Professor A. Somshekhar Rao, sir. It is my honor and privilege to introduce Professor K. Somshekhar Rao, sir, who will be delivering a talk on information and learning resources in COVID-19 era. Professor K. Somshekhar Rao is one of the dynamic professors well known in the country. After obtaining distinctive academic and professional qualifications, sir has joined as lecturer in the Department of Library and Information Science, Andhra University, in the year 1985. With his modest beginning in teaching, sir has reached the peak by producing 23 PhDs and 85 MPhils under his dynamic research guidance on various topics related to library and information science. Worked for more than 30 years and retired as a professor in the year 2017. During his tenure, he also served as honorary librarian of Dr. V.S. Krishna Library, Andhra University, and was a member of Academic Senate, Andhra University. He was also a subject expert for the Department of Library and Information Science of various universities, such as Utkal University and Berhampur University. His research work was honored with two best thesis awards, that is Kovuri Gangireddy Gold Medal and Srimati and Sri Aula Jayaprada Cash Award. Sir published more than 110 research articles in both national and international journals. Besides this, sir authored and edited 12 books. He is a member of various professional bodies such as Indian Library Association, International Society for Knowledge Organization, Indian Association of Teachers in Library and Information Science, Andhra Pradesh Public Library Association. He was a visiting professor to USA, UK, and Bangladesh. Above all, sir is a wonderful person filled with ethical values and helpful nature. I'm really proud to say that I have done my MPhil under esteemed guidance of Professor K. Somshekhar Rao, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation, sir. Thank you. Over to Professor Somshekhar Rao, sir. Sir, are you there?
Sir, unmute, sir. Unmute yourself.
Sir.
Yes.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Honorable Principal Father Victor Emmanuel, Dr. G.A. Prasad, Mrs. Rosa Mane, and other team responsible for this webinar, and my professional colleagues, student friends. I'm very happy to share my experiences with you, particularly professional experiences with you regarding this online learning resources, how they help in this COVID environment. So all of us speak now online classes, online discussions, and so on. Even from the primary school level also, people speak of online courses, etc. This we have been doing since for a long time. But the only thing for library professionals that is a lacuna or some kind of backwardness is we are unable to market ourselves. That's the biggest problem. We serve the people in different ways, and great people appreciate the libraries, library services. So in keeping in all these things, I would like to share my experiences in library profession. Rajaman, how to connect this video? A PowerPoint presentation. One minute. Hope you are able to see my presentation. Information and learning resources in COVID-19 era. This is the period. Well, whether it is COVID era or normal environment, education to continue. So we cannot stop education. What are the problems we may come across in our society from time to time? Today we are facing the COVID-19, and at a later time we may face another thing, but education should continue. Otherwise, you cannot find the prosperity of society. So therefore, to continue the education, the education institutions are very much necessary. When education institutions are necessary to support the education system, a kind of system is necessary, that what we call libraries or library and information systems. So all the education institutions are associated with well-established libraries. So for example, the library of Loyola College, I visited several times. It's one of the best libraries at degree college level. And their functions are user-friendly. So this is the way many libraries are serving the people, serving the education institution. So therefore, libraries have to play a great role in education and education development. This is one aspect. Another aspect in COVID-19 we have to remember technology and education. In technology, in the absence of technology, it would be very difficult. We cannot think of this many things which we are seeing now. Say, even right now, I am sitting at Visakhapatnam, and the participants are throughout India or maybe outside India. They are well connected. They are able to listen to me. And after a while, you may ask me any clarifications or any questions. This is all possible only technology. And application of technology is very much important. In libraries, now the professionals are well-trained, well-computer-oriented. They could do many things which are necessary for user and user community. Now, the next aspect we have to keep in mind, off-campus to online. This off-campus business to online business, sometimes they call off-campus. Off-campus, this is being followed, this concept, in engineering college libraries in Andhra Pradesh very much, even throughout the country also. But as far as my knowledge is concerned, most of the engineering colleges are giving remote learning facility to their users. If this facility the users want to use to get information from library resources, definitely they need some kind of facilities like broadband, reasonable broadband, etc. So now people, we talk about cloud computing too. So cloud computing is a little advanced about this broadband. But remember, the broadband and cloud computing are not same. The broadband technology is not suitable for cloud computing. Therefore, cloud computing is a bit expensive, and we have to invest a certain amount to have that facility. But there are other things which we can get easily, just like we are connecting with Google or YouTube or Zoom. We can use these things and offer facilities to users outside the campus. And remember, there are two concepts on this area. One is, when remote learning facility is made available, where is the need to keep open the library for a long time? This is definitely fit for advanced countries, where I visited UK in one university library. It is Brunel University Library. They call it a very small library, but their collection is more than 50 lakhs or so. That's their collection. And they keep open the library for 5 days a week, Saturday and Sunday closed. And library kept open for morning 10 to 5. And I asked them, why this kind of facility? And they said, our users can connect at any time to our library resources, wherever they may, whether they are in here or elsewhere, it doesn't make any difference. And they are computer savvy or technologically, they are well in advance. But whereas in Indian condition, it's not so. Many students may not have that kind of facilities. So therefore, still the libraries are to be open for reasonable hours. Well, so as I told you, for any education, information is an essential item. Or sometimes we may call it knowledge, sometimes we may call it data. But in this context, let us use confined only to information. So where we can find information? So information we can find in books, non-book materials, electronic resources, manuscripts, and many, many more items. All these items are kept in libraries. A while ago, Rosa Mani is saying that a lot of resources are available in Lila College Library. So therefore, the information resources are available in libraries. When information resources are available in library, the next question, next job of the library or the librarian is how to use them. Say for example, start from the beginning, books. In true sense, books are the main sources of information. As well, when the books are in the library, when the books component is dominated in the library, to give access to books to the users, mere cataloging and classification is sufficient. Therefore, if you visit any old libraries or big libraries, you will find card catalogs, very huge card catalogs. When the information started publishing in periodicals and journals and reports, etc., the cataloging is not sufficient or suitable to provide access to the information available in periodicals and journals. Therefore, we shifted to indexing services and abstracting services. Along with time, most of the libraries are now shifted to electronic resources. When electronic resources are made available in the library has to change drastically. They have to use the information technology, communication technology, computers, different varieties of software, and so on. Internet technology, and so on. That is the relation between the information's growth of information resources and their use. When you come to the role of the library and information centers in education, in Indian libraries, librarians provide access to information sources, and also we educate the user in many social respects. Though we never claim, but we educate the users how to behave with others, how to help others, how to cooperate each other, how to help yourself. These things involuntarily we teach them. Therefore, to fulfill the objectives of education in any institution, the role of library and information centers are very, very significant and indispensable. Now, let us see what is then, when we say library is an essential item in education, and what is library? We say it's a trinity of library. So we say books or resources, students, we say users, and library staff. These are the three basic items one may come across in any kind of library throughout the globe. And we have to find the relation between these three items. Now, today's discussion, we are more concerned with sources, information resources in libraries. As I have already mentioned different varieties and their role. When resources are to be used thoroughly in the library, we have to develop various bridges or mechanisms to bring together the user and the resources. I told you the print resources and books and periodicals, there is no problem for books and print resources. Mere cataloging and classification would help a lot. For periodicals, indexing services and abstracting services would do a lot. But when you come to the electronic resources, there is a lot of items we have to discuss and lot of things we have to learn. Not only learning ourselves, we have to make the users also to learn through various programs, and popularly we call it information literacy. Now, what is learning? In simple terms, let us try to understand learning. It is a process of bringing changes in behavior of the learner through experience. That means whatever, when any user learns anything from a book or a journal or electronic sources, his or her behavior should change in a right direction. That's very, very important. So that is the very fundamental purpose of learning. When you listen, when you understand, when you observe something, you should perceive, and that perception should help us change in our behavior. It results in the acquisition of knowledge, skills, interests, and attitudes. So by this way, we learn knowledge, we gather knowledge, and develop skills and interests, and we bring a lot of change in attitudes. If you compare yourself from your childhood to present days, by learning many things, not only in institutions or colleges or libraries, even other areas too, we find our behavior would change based on the learning system. Now, how to understand resource? What is the resource? Resource, it's a relative term. A resource is a source from which benefit is produced. So as long as any resource is not gives any benefit or advantage or a help, it cannot be called a resource. So resources are relative. Say for example, if you offer food for vegetarian food for non-vegetarian, he may not like. Or if you offer non-vegetarian food for a vegetarian, he may not like, vice versa. Though the quality of the food may be good. In the same way, a particular resource may be useful to a particular group. Say for indexing and abstracting services are useful only for researchers and active users, not for passive users or potential users. Whereas databases, etc., are very, very, very useful for the present day students or present day users. It is acquired to accomplish activity or to achieve desired outcomes. This is where, by understanding the resource and its benefits, we reach our destination or our pre-established goals. Now, learning resources. Learning resources are those devices and procedures that help to make teaching and learning more interesting. This is very, very important. So the learning resources, let's say in libraries, we say, as a indexing service or a journal, we say it's a learning resource. That learning resource should help the teaching process as well as the learning process, and it should create a kind of interest in learning and assimilating knowledge, stimulating or more reinforcing, that means strengthening more and more and more effective. So by rereading the same book or same knowledge, definitely the ideas go on strengthening further and further, thereby the incumbent would be able to give another knowledge or related knowledge or a refined knowledge on the same subject. So, importance of learning resources. Effective usage of proper learning resources help the user to construct more than superficial knowledge, that is building in-depth knowledge on a particular subject, and also developing their individual learning strategies, values, attitudes, and genuine skills. So this is, here the emphasis is, the learning resources should help the user to understand in-depth, not superficial. That is very, very important. So if you read a learning resource, if you read a book carefully, if you observe an item carefully and thoroughly, definitely your knowledge would definitely different when compared to the casual reading. If you read a book, while reading the book, one should forget the environment. You should not see the what is happening here and there, then he is putting his total concentration on the book or the knowledge. Then if that knowledge is perceived, definitely the behavior of the individual or the knowledge of the individual, subject knowledge of the individual, definitely goes on improving and helps the development of subject further. Libraries, learning resources. In libraries, in this context, the resources I grouped into print and non-print. Regarding books, I have already explained to you. Regarding non-print, that is we are focusing. And in non-print, there are different types of learning resources. Mostly we call it digital resource. It's a commonly used when any electronic resources connected are getting benefited through net, we call it as a digital. Still further, there is other meaning also that is not necessary here. So therefore, the learning resources identified five types. One is stimulation. The resource aids teachers' explanation and allows learners to test out their ideas and experiment. So the stimulation, most of us have tea or coffee after working continuously for 2 hours or 3 hours. So this simply we say we stimulated our mind. That means refreshing. So when we learn anything, that sort of stimulate the learner, it could be a teacher or a student. Animation. This can demonstrate process which are difficult to describe or show into two dimensions. This is mostly we use in research, graphs or tables. Through table, we could explain a matter of 30 minutes or 40 minutes in a span of 2-3 minutes. That is the advantage of animation. If you apply the real techniques of animation, we can explain many things so easily and so interestingly to the users. And here, while animating the information, one should keep in mind the level of the users, that is the target users. If you do not keep in mind target users, sometimes it could be underestimated or overestimated. Quiz. This allows learners to test their own understanding and knowledge. And next one is electronic textbooks. All learners can access a copy of the relevant sources. This is the advantage of electronic textbook is when compared to the normal textbook, it cannot be tampered. It can be accessed by many people. It gets never damaged. These are the advantages of electronic books. And the learning object. This is another type of digital resource. This resource has been designed to meet the specific learning outcomes and can be incorporated and reused in a range of learning materials. This is the best example is NPTEL lessons or SWAYAM courses, etc. And the learning resources use are the advantages. So, while the learning resources should have clarity and it should give excellent clarity, because in electronic learning resources, we use audio and video. Thereby, we can catch the attention of the users so easily and so simply. Attention and interest. While looking at the audio and the video, getting the attention and interest is very, very easy. Motivation. So when the attention and interest are successful, motivation is guaranteed. Accelerate sense. So once the individual is motivated, he can accelerate, he can speed up his sense. He can understand things so fastly. He need not observe the entire thing systematically from beginning to end. just by going passing through, he can understand the end product. Minimize effort and time. Scientific approach. This is a systematic approach. Comprehensive understanding. This is out of all, if you combine all these things, the comprehensive understanding is achieved. And while selecting the resources, not only in COVID environment, in general environment, we should give always preference to the user and user's capacity. When we come to the institutions, we always consider teachers and users. Keep in mind these two things, we should go for selection of resources. While selecting the resources, you have to see the A's. So the electronic resources for school libraries and college libraries are totally different. And the maturity of the users. So while we speak to the faculty members, we should be very, very careful. And while you speak to the students, we should not be that much careful, need not be. Because whatever we say, the user, the student user would ready to accept. But when you talk to the faculty members, because he's a learned man, his knowledge is definitely superior to our knowledge in that area. So therefore, based on his requirements, based on his demand, based on his system, process, we should attend the teacher users, intellectual level. So here, this is, you should understand this intellectual level, experienced librarians will understand this intellectual level very easily. When two users comes to a library, the librarian may suggest one user to book and another user to journal articles. They depends upon intellectual level. So if the where the student level is not that level, if we suggest advanced reading, definitely he will get fumbled and he may think that he is not fit for that environment. Whereas if you give the vice versa, low level to the intellectual people, definitely they may not develop their interest further in that area. Motives. Social environment for the learners. This is very, very important. This is well connected to the COVID environment today. So in social environment, now students may not come to colleges continuously. Thereby, their visits to library may be minimized. If that is the environment, that is one factor. And the economic factors of the users, the other social factors, if you keep all these things in your mind, and particularly degree colleges, most of the users are financially not that bright. I'm not saying poor, but not that bright. They cannot go for a broadband, they cannot go for electronic gadgets so easily. Therefore, in degree college environment, even in university environment, the library should provide excellent facilities to the user communities, keeping in mind all these social factors. This value of learning, this is not necessary. And simplicity. Learning resources should be simple enough so that a student can understand it and enhance his or her learning. This is the one of the factors. Even while I'm teaching in Andhra University or anywhere, most of the students are from rural background. They cannot understand English so easily. Therefore, they said that it would be very difficult for us to understand you, sir. What should we do? Then I say simply, read the simple books like Chandamama in English. that is a magazine, simple magazine, or books written by Rajaji, Mahabharata, Ramayana. They are very, very simple. And if you, once you start, you go continuously. So in that way, the learning resources should be simple, keeping in mind the user's capacity. If the learning resource is not simple, it will be very difficult to understand. The user may lose their interest. Say, for example, if you read the biographies, some great people biographies, if you read, just going through one or two pages, we stop there because we cannot understand them. So therefore, in libraries, we should keep in mind the users at large, not single user or group of users. Relevance and suitability. So this is a important concept in degree college libraries and university libraries. Whenever a source is acquired in the library or subscribed in the library, whether it is relevant or suitable, that's more important. Say, while I was working honorary librarian in Dr. V. Krishna Library, a mathematics professor's son came to me and offered his father's books to library. So then I went to their residence and we shifted those books from the residence to library. And because since I'm not a mathematics student or mathematics, I do not have any mathematics background. So I asked one of the professors in mathematics to see the books. And that professor told me that these books are excellent books, but they are not useful now because now the syllabus has changed. No university is offering this kind of syllabus. Therefore, this is not necessary in libraries. So therefore, that is a burden to library. To keep the books in the library, we have to spend a lot of amount and a lot of effort. So therefore, while we subscribe a resource or acquire a resource, while we accept a resource, we should see the relevance, suitability in longer sense, not immediate sense. And let me say one of my experience. While I was in London, I went to a university, a small public library. I asked for a book. The librarian immediately said that, would you want the book immediately? Said, yes, if you want, if you get it, it's well. Then he said that, we won't buy that books. You wait for 2 days. We get that book from nearby library within 2 days. And I asked them, why you are not buying that book? Then they said that, so space is a big problem. And the book which you asked may not be read by many people. So therefore, we borrow that book. And once you read the book, again, we send back the source to that parent library. So these are things we have to keep in mind. Otherwise, it will be very difficult to maintain libraries for a long time. That is one of the biggest challenges in Indian university libraries and degree college libraries. To withdraw a book, it is very, very difficult. You have to follow a lot of procedure and process. Whereas in advanced countries, once the library committee decides these books are no more read by our users, the users who comes to library now and then. So if they feel that, then they keep all those books in the central place and for sale. If anybody purchases the books, they give at off price or throw away price. If the books are not taken by anybody, then they will send to nearby libraries, or sometimes they ask the users to take away. Otherwise, it will be very difficult to keep up the library to the expectations of the users. That is one of the biggest challenges in Indian libraries. Things to be considered while selecting learning resources: financial budget, trained teachers. These two things are very, very necessary. So most of the libraries are going for electronic resources. Just yesterday, one of my students presented his YOS, PhD YOS, and one of the experts asked him, you are suggesting excellent sources, electronic sources and facilities. What about the budget? Would the libraries are coming forward to provide that kind of budget? Then he said that definitely they may not provide to the expert level, but most of the libraries, particularly engineering college libraries, are moving towards on those lines. His experience, he told me, he told us, when he was working some 20 years back or so, their library budget was 5 lakhs or so, but now it is to 70 to 80 lakhs. And trained teachers or trained librarian, when we get in the electronic resources, electronic databases, that kind of resources, the librarian should be trained thoroughly. This we call information literacy. So training to the kids, librarian, training to the users, these two things are very much necessary for electronic learning resources. Resources and education. These three types of, we identified three types. One is human resource, physical resource, and library resource. First two things are not well connected to our world. The third one is library resources and electronic resources, already I discussed with you. And e-learning, what is e-learning? Now, when you go for e-resources, you should understand e-learning and types of e-learning. The concept of e-learning, which came into existence due to the development of information communication technology, with its communication and sharing facilities, greatly influenced education institutions. So this e-learning facilities is the result of communication technology, as I told you already. So therefore, all libraries should make use of the communication technology facilities thoroughly. E-learning is the delivery of education, which includes activities related to instruction, teaching, and learning through various electronic media such as internet, intranets, extranets, satellite, TV, video, audio, tapes, and CD-ROMs. And e-learning types, synchronous, asynchronous. Synchronous, this is the involvement between the teacher and student thoroughly, whereas in asynchronous, the teacher and student involvement is there, but not continuously. The student may give some questions or clarifications to the teacher by mail, and the teacher would respond according to his convenience. That is asynchronous. But in synchronous, spontaneously, we get the answers from the teachers. And e-learning websites. These are some of the e-learning websites I mentioned here. I will open the websites. You just see them. This is one is Khan Academy. This is an American non-profit academy, and it is very, very useful for English books. And it is, as I told you, it is free. This Khan Academy website can be used by degree college librarians so easily. And the next one is online MIT online courses. And if you see the IGNU, this is the National Open University in India. It offers excellent facilities. And another one is Academic Earth. These are all free sites. We need not. Here, in Academic Earth, you will find a program. You have to select a degree. Here, you will find three options: bachelor's degree, master's degree, doctorate, certificate, diploma. So you just offer for bachelor's degree and then select a category. You want business management, computer technology, or criminal education and teaching. You select education and teaching, that is subject. Select a subject. in education and in elementary education or primary education, say let us elementary education, start my journey. So here you will find the books, facilities, find school programs, etc. These are the various facilities available. One can make use of these things. And then virtual libraries. This is a virtual library in the sense we don't find the library, but we get the facilities as if there is a library. The virtual library concept is a result of efforts of various librarians to provide faster access to quality and authoritative information available on web. For virtual libraries or digital libraries or electronic libraries, network connectivity is mandatory. If there is no network connectivity, forget about all these things. See, in virtual libraries, this network connectivity is very, very important. Through web, we can get access to any library. You can get access to World Congress Library in USA or British Museum in London and so on. Websites of virtual libraries. This is the International Public Library. Information to find popular essays. Many things, role reserve of Shakespeare's Macbeth, the advantages of nursing audit and nursing practice. If you once you go to this, you will find further aspects.
Kindly upload a copy of the book to which we have to review in this WhatsApp group along with the website well in advance, because
in that way, Barclaycom, InfoMine, Kentucky Library. I'm just listing just few. There are many, and particularly this National Digital Library. I will try to open it. You will find it now. This is the National Digital Library. This is one part is study at home. You can study at home by clicking. If you want school information, school level, this is, and CBSE examination preparatory, and engineering, science, humanities, literature, law and management, etc. And second part is research repository COVID-19. This is relevant to today. Scholarly publications, data sheet sets, documents and videos, journal conferences, ideas, funding, challenges, startup, this, and feature collection. This is changes every day. Say, not today. Today they put birth centenary of Satyajit Ray on this day. Say, if you go to on this day, you will find the important features of on this day. Say, related to, say, now something related to Abdul Kalam. In this way, you will find the information. Persons of the week. Who are the prominent persons in this week? Vincent Walk and so on. Topics of the week, talks and webinars. If you go to this, here you will find the list of webinars throughout the globe. So this National Digital Library, this is one of the best facility available. This is a government project. One can get access. One need not go to library even. The only thing is we should have proper platform in our desktop or in computer and reasonable network connectivity speed. If these two things are there, we can get access to National Digital Library and get excellent benefit. This is the structure of NDL Study Home. As I mentioned, this is for schools. CBSE examination preparatory engineering, science, humanities, literature, and law and management. This is in research repository, you will find already as for mentioned you, scholarly publications, data sets, etc. And non-official items. And besides this, you will find excellent e-journals at free of cost. The one is use this InfoNet. This is exclusively for universities, university libraries, and that type of institutions. And UGC Analyst, this is now for degree college environment. But this InfoNet now is called Sodh Sindhu, Sodh Ganga, and they bifurcated. And OpenJGate, this is also a free of cost. You will find excellent information on OpenJGate. And DOAJ, this is a user-friendly database, a directory of open access journals. And you will find information on many subjects available in journals throughout the world. This is very, very useful. And if you want to prepare an article in simple level, this directory of open access journals is suitable and sufficient. And JCCC, JGate Custom Consortia content, this is also provides e-journal facilities and other databases. There are many databases that are providing lot of information either at free of cost or very, very nominal price for institutions. And popular online resources, Wikipedia, OSCAN Aspect, online encyclopedias, Encyclopedia.com, Encyclopedia Britannica, Encartra, Encyclopedia of Simpson, Information Please, and so on. And at present, many open learning resources are available and suitable to the educational requirements of various levels of education. In open learning resources, the user has full freedom to access the use them. This is one of the appealing feature of open learning resources is full freedom to users to access them wherever they want, whenever they want, the way they want. And once they download the information, they can manage the information they like, the way they like. The college education, a good number of open resources are available and thoroughly used by the respective users. So now, in all colleges, and particularly in engineering colleges, the users are using the open source resources so thoroughly. To make use of these resources, the level of users towards electronic resources and their knowledge on internet, etc., are important factors. In this context, a suitable informational literacy program be organized. So, as I already mentioned once or twice, to electronic resources appears from time to time. And the greatest disadvantage for the libraries is the exports of electronics. They add a feature, a new feature always to the products. So therefore, to make use of those electronic gadgets or products, we too should understand the basics of those features. So these, the basics we learn through informational literacy programs. Sometimes the vendor, they themselves come and conduct in the library, thereby we learn, and in turn, the library professionals would explain those information literacy programs to these teachers and users for thorough use of learning resources made available in these libraries. So, thank you for your patient listening. If you have any questions or if you want to add anything, you please.
Thank
Hello.
Sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for your informative session, sir. Now I request Dr. G.A. Prasad Rao sir to take question and answer. Over to Dr. Prasad Rao sir.
Shomshekhar Rao garu, my beloved professor and my mentor, and other participants and organizers, very good evening to one and all. There are three questions,
please.
So two from audience, sir. One from my side. The first question posed by Kale Rao Jagadish. He wanted to know, sir, how to implement 5 laws in this COVID-19 pandemic in our educational institutions. I repeat, sir, how to implement 5 laws of life science in this COVID-19 pandemic in our educational institutions, sir. This question posed by Mr. Jagadish.
Okay. Say, let me say a very straight answer to him.
Sir.
The 5 laws were developed by Ranganathan long back. When Ranganathan devised the 5 laws, that time the environment of libraries was different. But still, if you change the laws relevant to the present day, still we can apply those 5 laws to the COVID environment. Say, books are for use, information for use. So if you want information for use, now information is available in electronic resources. So we have to train ourselves and we have to train the users. So every book is reader, or every reader is book. So that means every resource should have a reader. Every reader should have his resource. So for all these things, you should have excellent database techniques, database management, and save the time of the user. So if you fulfill these 3 laws successfully, definitely we can augment the 4th law of library science. 5th law is library is a growing organism. So information sources is growing in libraries forever as long as mankind is there. So in that way, we can implement or we can see the 5 laws in the present day context.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Question posed by Mr. Dr. Kaladhar Arnepalli.
Yes.
To be taken by library professionals to high power importance in serving users online.
Please repeat it again.
What are the measures to be taken to hype our
measurement? So how that means he wants to know us how to help the users so thoroughly.
Yes, measures, sir.
Measures, what measures? So the one measure is, as I told you, most of the librarians, including Dr. Kaladhar, is doing a good job to their users. As I told you, the biggest lacuna with us is we are not able to market, give a publicity to our services. And it's one thing is, whenever any user comes to you, you listen carefully, listen totally. Though you know answer in the beginning, listen first carefully, give his reasonable time and tell them. Then they will view in a different way. And another thing is, if you want to help the users thoroughly, you should, librarians, particularly engineering college librarians, I need not say specifically to you because you are already doing, you have to update your knowledge from time to time. The one way is attending this kind of webinars or seminars or discussions, group discussions, or learned gatherings, learned discussions. Thereby, we can increase the use of users. This is one aspect. Another aspect is, in real sense, I told you in the last webinar in St. Joseph College School, if you want to increase to the expected level or maximum level, hype, whatever term you are using, right? The education system or the examination system changes. Unless the education system is not changed, not library oriented. You cannot bring all the users forcefully to libraries. Because if an assignment is given, the student should go to library for 10 days or 15 days. That should be the nature of the assignment. So that kind of academic efforts should be made from teachers. Then definitely we have been doing and we are doing, we will do forever. From our side, it's very clear. But the only is that environment should also be created from the educationists, particularly from teachers. Hope Dr. Kalada got the answer.
Sir, thank you. The third question, it's from me, sir. In your one of the slides, learning resource use, there is a new term your good self used, sir. Accelerate sense.
Oh, accelerate sense.
Kindly explain, sir.
So this accelerate means speed up. Acceleration means speed up.
Sir.
When you learn something, this is, I can give a simple example. If your daughter starts learning cutting the vegetables for first time, first day, you may tell that this is the way you cut the onion, this is the way you peel it, you cook. If you leave her for two, three days, she will improve her sense in a different ways. She cut any kind of vegetable by applying that sense. So once you learn, automatically you keep on accelerating, that itself accelerates the knowledge and accelerates the sense. And yes, I tell you, even otherwise, you can do a simple example. When you talk to me in a different way, when you talk to Rosamani in a different way.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
When you talk to Kalagar in a different way.
Yes,
when you talk to your father, that is your honorable principal, you talk in a different way. This is that's called accelerate sense.
Nice, sir. Because it's a new term I come across in that learning resource. Thank you very much, sir. These are the some general questions asked by two participants, sir.
Please.
One is there any LIS course in Loyola you are going to start? We are not going to start, sir. And another thing, one gentleman, Mr. Jagadish, again, he asked, are there any free sites for online journals, sir?
Yeah, that is Director of Open Access Journal, DOAJ.
Yes, sir.
There are many, but
this is very useful. Yes, sir. So these are the questions posed by the participants, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. Thank you for giving me opportunity to share my experience with the learning professionals. So I thank you, the management of Loyola College, Dr. Prasad, Dr. likely to be Dr. Rosamani, and technical team for this webinar and others. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Now I request Dr. Diya Prasad Rao, sir, to propose a vote of thanks.
Thank you. My pleasure to propose vote of thanks for this webinar session. Information and learning resource in COVID-19 era. The theme was suggested by our IQSE coordinator, Dr. G. Srinivas Rao, and supported by our NIRF coordinator, my brother and friend, Mr. GM Srirangam, and with these two gentlemen support, we have started this particular webinar process. I thank these two, and I thank God Almighty for giving us the all sorts of supports. And from my bottom of heart, I sincerely thank our beloved Father Principal, Reverend Father Victor Emmanuel, for his guidance and support. In Father's talk, I admired when he was offered by chemistry, but he so darefully he went to that rector and asked for mathematics. Whenever I think of mathematics, there is a great link between mathematics and LIS corruption. Reverend Father, our Father of Library Science, Padma Shri Dr. S.R. Ranganathan Garu also hails from Department of Mathematics from Madras University. And because of Dr. S.R.R., our library science profession in India is shining and shining forever. So, Father, with your mathematics background, I always feel there is a great bondage between mathematics and LIS. Thank you, Father, for your continuous support. And whatever and whenever we ask and we approach for the sake of library and its works, you are always extending your helping hand. Please continue with all those things, Father. And finally, your poem really touched us and it's really inspiring, Father. Thank you once again, dear Father. As the saying goes on, still waters run deep. In Telugu, it's called Nicharanga Unde Neeru Lotekku Antaru. It aptly suits our beloved professor, my mentor, Professor Somashekhar Rao Garu, who delivered a wonderful, in-depth and timely lecture today. I can proudly announce that 2 days back, Sir also openly announced Vaivavas was conducted. One of his scholars, Dr. Mahesh, Uma Mahesh, was awarded PhD. With that PhD, about 2 days back, Sir has completed 33 PhDs and 50 plus MPhils. It's really a proud feeling, dear sir, because so many professionals you have produced, and all those produced to my all those professionals who all comes out from your end are well placed in very, very good position, sir. And another great admiring feature, you never say no to any work. That's another admirable quality we all observe, sir. From your lecture, I have taken 3 important dimensions, sir. Especially, you have wonderfully and elaboratively explained about advantages of electronic textbooks and virtual libraries. It's really useful session, sir. And space problems and importance of resource sharing. This is a timely thing, sir. Wherever, whichever, whatever be the library, how advanced it may be, but the space problem is a problem, especially in our Indian context, sir. These 2 aspects are elaboratively explained by your good self, and many were posed in the chat box that your session is very informative, excellent, and many other interesting words they have shared through chat box, sir. So, my dear sir, we are very, very grateful and thankful to you all, and I extend great thanks from our institution also, from the management also, sir. Thank you once again, sir.
Thank you very much.
I also thank Mrs. Rojamani, our PG librarian,
thank you.
And other librarians. Mr. Lakshman, Mr. Bala, and Mr. Venkatratnam and others, they really extended. Special mention to Madam Rojamani, with her technical and tech-savvy knowledge, really made this webinar a fruitful one, an excellent one, a successful one. Finally, I am grateful to our student community, especially to mention Brother Aurakya Raj, Mr. Oday Reddy, and Ms. Bala Saraswati for their cooperation and helping hand in their technical issues for the conduct of this, for the smooth conduct of this webinar today. Thank you, dear student friends. Finally, if I fail, if I don't mention the webinar participants, thank you, my dear professional friends, for your time and valuable feedbacks. And thank you all. Thank you. God bless all. Thank you, sirs. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye to all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Namaste. Namaste.